Iceland coming up to the 1.8 kilometer split. Chuuk with the remainder. Tamira Bulatova of Russia is ahead of Voronina, also of Russia. And in third place, or third and fourth, the two Norwegians. That was going through 3.8. Those two leaders have gone through 4.4 now. Borchugova.
Blasted off the top of the Calipari track. They had the best time in the first run and the second run. They also had a great start, great downtime, and they win the inaugural first event.
Switzerland up once again, the last throw of the eighth end. Another speedy one knocks it right out as sweet. Maria Batilova gets it started for Team Russia here with a slap shot from deep. Watch it again. Just slings it into that top left-hand corner there. Now Russia leads 1-0, but they wouldn't be done yet. A nice pass here from Elena Dergacheva over to Elvatina Shitareva. Gets another one in here for Russia. Watch the replay. Keep your eye on number 59 here. A beautiful pass to...
We are away in the 30K mass start for the men freestyle. Eight laps, four on the red course, four on the blue. And each lap 3.75 kilometers long. As they head out of the stadium for the first time at a good clip too, and off to the right there in three is Ivan Kirillov. Good strong family
of the Czech Republic. Studies at the Czech Technical University in Prague. And a good jump for her.
Ready to test those nerves. Karolina Shrapek was expected to be a strong contender for medal count silver in the Super G, the bronze in the giant slalom 2 years ago in Turkey. On top of that, the woman for the years at Kukucha Academy of Physical Education in Katowice, Poland, posted the fastest time in both training runs to expectations. First of the four events was high. However, being sixth out of the gate, she never really hooked things up. Second fastest through the first split, able to improve from there.
Paco Rassat of France, the next challenge. And Rassat, having seen the first two in front of him fail to finish, might just be a little wary of this pattern of gates set by Honda Hiroki of Japan. Rassat, who skied very nicely in the parallel team events. On that time split. And now he transitions from steep to flat.
They tuck, so not quite as difficult, so it has to be performed well. Emma Weiss gets us underway. Here, 17th, a seventh at the World Junior Championships. But Leah Bayard, second last night, is looking for gold this evening. Both racers off to a ferocious start, where the Russian on the left of your screen has started slightly quicker, but the rhythm from the German on the right is slightly better. Therefore, she's gone in front throughout the mid section of the course. Everything's looking down the hill. Everything's in rhythm. Everything's intact, and the air's good from Leah Bayard, and she should go through to the final.
First run, 81.6 points, and he really dominated the competition after that 81.6, 86.4 points. His winning score, first started the skating moguls. He was 10th in the slope style earlier this week, and it was a super performance from John Leonard. Studies at the University of Oregon. Fourth medal in freestyle skiing for Team USA.
Now to the men's side. In this competition, we have the gold, silver, and bronze medalists from Grenada in 2015. You're looking here at the gold medalist from there. This is Pavel Kolmakov of Kazakhstan. Along with his gold in Grenada, he was 10th at the Sochi Olympics in 2014. And a good
from Russia in green, and Ekaterina Oltseva also from Russia in red, and they're away. It's a storming start from all four competitors. Ekaterina Oltseva, who was the top qualifier this morning from Russia, goes into that high banked left turn in control early doors, and it's a great lead as well, ducking all the way, trying to stay aerodynamic as we hit the rollers, absorbing every single one, trying to keep speed and skis on the snow as well. The battle for second is going to be thrilling. Nina Birch currently holding.
Jan Ivan Enkevort has to travel away to find any usable snow, given that his native Netherlands is as flat as a pancake. And to that end, he now finds himself studying at the University of Applied Sciences and Art in Lugano, Switzerland. The 27-year-old struggled a little in qualifying, finishing in fifth place with a score of 79.8 in the second run. Come the final, though, the Flying Dutchman really hit his form, combining some spectacular jumps with great technique. That's enough for a total score of 84.2 in second place at that stage, although he would slip down the leaderboard.
Semi-final one of the women's 500 metres is underway, and the two Russians have gone out into the lead here. Efremenkova leading the line from Malagic, and they've pulled away from Botagomez and Yang Yang. The Russians have come out hard and fast all day today. Efremenkova
broke the track record at the start of the first run, and he did the same again in the second run. A track record two consecutive times at the 50-meter mark for the bottom part of the track. Alexander Trepnev, the World Cup leader, did not take advantage. Had problems on this short, tight Winterberg track.
Bye. Top tens on the Europa Cup as well. Last result was in the Netherlands. Took a sixth there, going for the 50-50, trying to work the board all the way over the rails. So far, so good for Russia. And what they'll feel is if they can land their first run and get a score on the leaderboard, the pressure's really going to be off of them second run. The 180 to start with. Bogdanova on the Buda goes for the 360 seconds. The athletes pull away for the first ladies semi-final, and it's a fantastic start for two riders. Christina Pohl, no surprises there. She was 90 seconds in front of everyone yesterday in the time qualification. It's a Russia 1-2. Yulia Lapateva as well is going very strongly, but it's actually a Russia 1-2-3 as Maria Vasiltova is in third place. So it's a Russia top three so far, but only two can qualify. So as Christina Pohl pulls away so strongly early on, it's a back high left-hand turn, but she stays on the edges the whole time. It's so smooth. The race for second place is going to be the one to watch. Vasiltova, Lapateva will be fighting it out for a place in that big final later on. It looks as if that the young Russian, 23, 10th in 2013 in this event, is going so strongly, and it looks like it's going to be heartbreak for Yang Pohl and Lapateva as well. And there's a big
other than the more usual 22, they're really putting some of the competitors off their timing. China's Huang Shiying has a personal best of an 8th place finish in the World Cup events, that coming 2 years ago on home snow in Yabuli. A 23-year-old from Shenyang Sports University, a solid 5th in qualifying here.
Looks like we're ready to go. Beep signal, the start of the race with both racers leaving the starting gate at the same time. Harim Yong on the red course. Looks like she's had a slightly slower start. Elizaveta Salikova on the blue side is gaining some speed, but one thing we know about
Morgan Cyprès of France. They're skating to Angels and Demons, Requiem for a Dream. Here's see the death spiral executed very well. This pair are three-time French champions. And they competed at the 2014 Sochi Winter Olympics, where they placed 10th. They've also competed at three world championships. Dance.
Cute little ending for this.